Hello friends, today I am showing you hatching and with the fine liners and well in Copic they're called multi-liners and then the microns they are fine liners, Pigma, micron. And then also I do have others like Sharpie. Now this one isn't labeled like as a size, but it's just a Sharpie fine pen, and it's about a 0.3 or it would be an 0.03, and they are labeled a little bit different. Like right here I have labeled the sizes, and 1.0 is, as you can see, very thick, and then most common there's a 0.5, and then you get into the Copics, and the microns go on a different numbering system, because see Copics they'll go 1, then 0.5, then 0.5, but then you get to the microns and they start 0.1, and now see you have an 0.5 in the micron, but it is not 0.5 millimeters, it's actually 0.45 millimeters. So they are about and they're real close, and so you always have an idea of what you're doing, but they're not exactly the same. And there's lots of other ways to shade, such as stippling and scrumpling and scribbling and all kinds of whatever, but today is just hatching and cross hatching. And you know what, to show you, I've done them, and to do it you're going to make 5 squares, and the reason why is because you have your whites, highlights, midtones, shadows, and blacks, and each one, as you can tell, gets darker as it goes. And then hatching is one direction, I should say. And then cross hatching is 2. Now, in cross hatching, you can get into as many lines as you wish, but for this example, I'm just doing 2. And I wanted to see, like, here's an example where I use hatching and contour. Contour hatching is where you just go with the shape of what you're doing. And you can definitely tell the gradients. And then here where it's really, really dark to make that tree trunk pop, that's when I used the thick one. The 1.0 Copic. And then everything else is various from, you know, 5 to, say, I don't know exactly, but I did switch them up. You can tell how, I mean, for these little ripples, I use very, very fine ones, and then up here, you know, much thicker. And also, the slower you move it, the thicker it's gonna be. And so see, you can tell when I was doing these how thick. Now of course there's more cross hatching at the bottom, but you can tell how they fade out, how it fades out. Well, that's when you flick it, and that way you get a thinner line, and that's how all of most of these are. You flick them, and that way they fade out, and that helps with the shading effect as well. And then see, you don't even need to flick next. Most all of this is flicked next to a line, but here, you know, a line is just a direction that causes your eyes to follow in a line. So here there's no actual line, so to speak, but I hatched it to where your eyes make it a line. And so, yeah. Now I did this. I have another example here. Now, I did color in this bottom part, but this is all cross-hatched and contour hatched, this rose, and you can tell how dark it gets. And then I even have an example here of where I was hatching and cross-hatching in this tree. Now, I did add some color, but I kept the hatching. You know, I just hatched it in color. And you can tell, to really give a three-dimensional effect, you know, cross-hatch at the bottom of your trees, wherever you want it really dark, and then, you know, go lighter when they're in the light. And, you know, instead of having to color this entire background, I just threw some hatching down. And now, see, what I did is I did three lines and three lines and three lines and three lines. And then, of course, sometimes, you know, I'll get off and throw in some more. And then I actually, where I wanted it darker, I just went over it twice, you know, to cause more shadow there. But that's how you can color a whole page and not use a ton of ink and take you, I don't know, a year or two to fill this in when I filled it in way less than a year. But so you can also do all this stuff with color fine liners as well. And this right here is an acrylic marker. Acrylograph is what it's called, and it's actually 0.7 millimeters, but I'm just going to demonstrate it so just so you can see that you can use whatever medium you wish, and it pretty much works. Remember, the first one is always blank white. That's your brightest white. And for the hatching, just see, same thing. You can tell it's much, the slower I go, the thicker the line is going to be. There, and come down here to the cross action hatching section. Do the same thing, just double it up. There. That is how you do that. And thank you for joining me. Definitely try it and grab anything you want. They come in all different colors and all. In fact, you know, here, I got this from Sketchbox. This is a whole little box of fine liners. And these are all 0.4s, I believe. Yeah, they say 0.4 millimeter, but they come out with a lot of ink. They're definitely not as thin as a Micron. But nonetheless, and follow me next time, and I will do the more ways of shading. But there's enough of them that I can do a video on each one and not get overwhelmed with all the information, and this way give you time to work on this simple process and then move up. And thank you. Keep on drawing and inking and create. Have a blessed day. Bye.